In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can add features to an assembly in Autodesk Inventor. Here I have a part with a gasket placed upon it. I have my two separate parts here, and you can see them assembled here. And I would like to create some holes that go through both parts. I want to make sure I model this the way it's going to be manufactured. If those holes are going to be pre-drilled individually in each part, then I need to go into each part file and add the holes in these locations so that they are part of the original part files. If instead I'm going to put parts together and then drill them at the same time, then I want to put those features here in the assembly mode. To add features to an assembly, it works just like it does when you're adding features to a part. I'm going to select my 3D model tab, then select my hole tool. I'll click to place my hole and locate it, adjust the value if necessary, and then I'm also going to adjust its termination to the bottom surface of this part. Then click OK. As you can see, that hole has been added to both of those parts. Obviously, I can go ahead and pattern it or create the holes for the other locations, but I'm just going to go ahead and save for now. And then I'm going to open up one of the underlying components. As you can see, the hole does not exist in the individual components. It only exists in the assembly environment. If I look at my model tree, I can see the individual parts, but then I can also see the individual features as a first level item as well. You can use most other modeling tools the same way. I could, for example, add in some fillets or chamfers. Often chamfers will be added in the assembly mode to prepare for welding. And then once again, when I go to open up the component itself, those chamfers do not exist in this file. They only exist in the scope of the assembly. That concludes this look at adding features to Autodesk Inventor assemblies.